So now we are going to start on page number 78. And we are going to study about the letter. The next letter that Miss Mason has received. Okay, what this letter is about. Who has sent this letter? Right? This is the main thing. So who sent this letter? This letter is from Wanda Pentronsky. Okay? She... Now, the thing is that what the letter which Peggy and Maddie had written to Wanda, was she able to receive it? If yes, why did she not reply? If not, then why is she writing a letter to the class in charge? What is the reason? Okay, so today we are going to start with this, page number 78. In order to relate it to the previous one, let us see. The last paragraph, now it was Christmas time and there was snow on the grounds. Christmas bells and a small tree decorated the classroom. On the last day of school, before the holidays, the teacher showed the class a letter she had received that morning. So, which time it was? It was the Christmas time. The class was also decorated with accessories for the Christmas Eve, a small Christmas tree and some hangings. They were seen around the class. And moreover, the air was filled with the sense of festivity. So everyone is going to enjoy the time there. And during that day, when it was the last day of the school, because after that, the holidays will commence. And at that time, what happened that the teacher has shown a letter, special letter that she has received that morning. You remember Wanda Pentronsky, the gifted little artist who won the drawing contest? So the teacher announced, so students, do you remember Wanda? Because she thought that by the time so many months has been elapsed, it has been passed, maybe they are not remembering Wanda Pentronsky. Or maybe all in the class, they must have forgotten about Wanda. But Peggy has also forgotten, but Maddie not. So the teacher asked, do you remember Wanda Pentronsky? Well, she has written me and I'm glad to know where she lives. Because now I can send her medal and I want to read her letter to you. So it means teacher is so concerned with her children too. She said, but now I'm happy as now I have received a letter from her and I have come to know where she lives. And moreover, I can send her the medal that she has received after winning the contest. Otherwise, the teacher was feeling whom to contact and where to send the certificate as well as the medal. I want to read her letter to you. Now, the teacher wants that the letter should be read in the class so that everybody can come to know. The class sat up with a sudden interest and listened intently. So everyone settled in the class. Everyone settled in the class and ultimately they sat in their seat, listening to the letter, to the contents of the letter very carefully. So, dear Miss Mason, how are you? And room 13. Please tell the girls they can keep those 100 dresses. Because in my house, I have 100 new ones and all lined up in my closets. I'd like that girl, Peggy, to have the drawing of the green dress with red trimming and her friend, Maddie, to have the blue one. For Christmas, I miss that school and my new teacher does not equalize with you. Merry Christmas to you and everybody. So, what she has written, see how concise the letter is, but how precise the wordings are being used by the writer. So, in very few words, in very few lines, the writer has very well explained. What are you writing? Close it down. I'm not saying anything, dictating anything. So, and how precisely he has explained the feeling. Okay? Close rest of the notebooks on your tables, please. Yes. So what she said, She first of all wished the teacher, and she has expressed her gratitude towards the teacher. And then she has told that she has told the, to tell the students or to the girls to keep those drawings of the 100 dresses. And she has made a special mention of the red dress with the green trimmings, and green dress with red trimmings, and that is meant for Peggy. And moreover, the blue one is meant for Maddie. She told that they can keep those drawings of the dresses. And she's saying that she's happy in the new school, but it is not equalizing the old one, and the new teacher is not equalizing the old one, because the time or the place where you have spent a lot of time, you feel yourself attached to that place. And this is what she has felt. She's trying to make new bonds with the new people in the new place, but she is more, in strong bond with her old teacher. And she wished Merry Christmas to all. And yours truly, Vanda Panchronsky. So, on the way home from school, Maddie and Peggy held their drawings very carefully. All the houses had wreaths and holly in the windows. Holly and wreaths, you know, na, which are being intertwined, okay, to formulate like garlands, okay, to formulate a layer. Wreath, samajhte ho na, what is wreath? Yes, with flowers, it can be twined together to formulate a long strip. It can be in circular, it can be long one, so that it can be molded into desired shape, right? So, and holly means other decorations that are being used for Christmas Eve. And so, while coming back home, Maddie and Peggy, they were holding their drawings very carefully. And all the houses, they were decorated with wreaths and holly in the windows. Outside the grocery store, hundreds of Christmas trees were stacked, and in the window, candy, peppermint sticks, and cornucopias of shiny transparent paper were strung. Okay, so cornucopias means decorative containers, okay, which are full of flowers and full of fruits. So different kind of embellishments, decorations, they can be seen outside the shop, and everything was beautifully placed there. So giving a complete festive atmosphere, and Maggie and Peggy, little bit absent-mindedly, they were passing through the marketplace. The air smelled like Christmas, and light shining everywhere reflected different colors on the snow. So light glittering, glimmering effect of the light that has been shown onto the ground, and ultimately everything is seen like Christmas festive season. Okay, it was giving out the smell of the Christmas, like baking of cakes, baking of pies, and all together, everyone making fun, everyone enjoying, giving some money for charity, and they were enjoying. But Peggy and Maddie, they are not so happy. They have something different in their minds. So let us see what. Hey, Peggy said, hey, this shows she really likes us. It shows she got our letter. And this is her way of saying that everything's all right. And that's that. So Peggy, she's trying to reason out that what her letter means. She wanted to explain that this letter, it has shown that she received their letter. And moreover, she has also, has forgotten about everything that has happened between them. And moreover, she was saying that this is her way of saying that everything has forgotten. This is what she is telling. Okay. So ultimately, she is trying to get all the things done, and ultimately feeling that now the matter or the chapter is over. Just to pay attention. Okay. I hope so, said Maddie sadly. She felt sad because she knew she would never see the little tight-lipped polished girl again and couldn't ever really make things right between them. Maddie, again thoughtful, what she said. Again, she was thoughtful and she did not spoke a word. Okay, and but she simply said, yes, I hope so that everything is going to be okay. But ultimately, what has happened? She was feeling sad deep inside. Why she's feeling sad deep inside? Because of the reason she thought that she would not be able to meet that tight-lipped girl again. She would not be able to get a chance to talk to her again. And ultimately, what will happen? That the burden she's carrying upon her heart, it will be carried forward. Because she wanted to say sorry. She went to Boggins High too. But she was not able to meet Vanda Pentronsky there. And for that reason, she's feeling burdened deep inside her soul, that she could have stopped all that has happened to that girl. As she was, you can say, an intermediate between Vanda and Peggy, and she was trying to do all the things. She was trying to stop, but as she was not able to stop. So what this means that cause whatever she was doing, she actually everything was worthless. Okay, so then she went home and she pinned her drawing over a torn place in the pink flood wallpaper in the bedroom. So finally, what happened? She went home. She was so attracted towards this drawing that there was some torn place in the wallpaper that was fixed, flowered wallpaper that was affixed to that of the wall. She put that drawing over there. The shabby room came alive from the brilliancy of the colors. The room, which was otherwise looking shabby, now it has turned to life because the brilliant colors of the drawing made by Vanda Pentronsky, it reflected and it has given a new look to the room. Mary sat down on her bed and looked at the drawing. Still, after coming home also, she was so engrossed in the thinking of Vanda that she never wanted to get separated. What she wanted that this should not end here. She wanted to talk to that girl again. It was deep in her thoughts that she should go, she should feel sorry, and she should not let it repeat to any other child after Vanda. But as she has not got a chance, she was still concentrating upon that picture which was affixed to that of the wall. And what she wanted to see that drawing. She had stood by and said nothing, but Vanda had been nice to her anyway. She was just thinking of the different ways how Vanda was made fun of, how everyone was talking to her. But she herself was feeling, anyway, what has happened, that has been passed. But Vanda was really nice to her. She has not said anything to her. Actually, Vanda has never said anything to any girl. Although everyone was making fun of her, but actually she was nice to all. Just giving one answer of how many dresses you have, she's always saying, I have 100 dresses all lined up in my closet. And even in the letter when she has written that, give those drawings of 100 dresses to all the girls, and I have still 100 dresses in my closet in my new house. This also shows that this thing has pricked her a lot. She was really feeling bad for all the fun that has happened to her. So, tears blurred her eyes and she gazed for a long time at the picture. So, tears were rolling down from her cheeks. It blurred her eyes. She was not able to see properly because her eyes were filled with tears of Medi. And she was just looking at the picture that was fixed to the wall. Then, hastily, she rubbed her eyes and studied it intently. Then, hurriedly, she rubbed her eyes and looked at the picture intently to find something in the picture. What is she trying to find in the picture? Yes, it is the face. The colors in the dress were so vivid. Vivid means clear, that she had scarcely noticed the face and head of the drawing. So the colors of the picture, they were so bright that she had hardly noticed the light colored faces that has been drawn over that drawing. It looked like her. Maddie, it really looked like her own mouth. So she looked at her face in the mirror also, touched her expression. Yes, it's me. It's my face that has been drawn over there. So why she has drawn that? Why it really looked like her own self? Wanda had really drawn this for her? Excitedly, she ran over to Peggy's house. So she was so excited that she was filled with, you can say, enthusiasm, and she immediately ran toward Peggy's house in order to tell her, have you seen your picture also? So Peg, she said, hey Peg, let me see your picture. No, she wanted to see the picture. What's the matter? Peggy asked, what has happened to you? Why are you asking it? As they cluttered up to her room, clutter means hurriedly moved up to their room where Wanda's drawing was lying face down on the bed. Peggy, she was not paying much attention. Peggy is a little bit carefree girl. Okay, she's not so deeply moved. She thought that if she's asking or making fun of Wanda, it is not because that she's making, it is not just because of that fun. Actually, she's asking her again and again, but because why Wanda is saying that she has 100 dresses, that if she is wearing daily one blue dress, right? Moreover, she thought that it is that she has won the contest. It is only because of her asking. Because whenever she is asking her how many dresses you have, daily she is getting an idea. Okay? And this is the reason why she won the contest. So they went up to the room. Maddie has fixed the photo onto the wall, but it was lying down on the bed in case of Peggy. Maddie carefully raised it. Look, she drew you. That's you, she exclaimed. And the head and face of this picture did look like Peggy. So she has shown this picture to Peggy. Peggy, see the face which is drawn over the picture. It is just like you. It is just like that she has drawn it for you. Okay? And ultimately, see your face exactly like you. It is drawn here. What did I say? She must have really liked us anyway. Peggy said, what? Surprise. What should I say to this? It really meant that she liked us. She did not hate us. Peggy is also looking the other sides. She has never thought that she hated them also. So, yes, she must have, agreed Maddie. And she blinked away the tears that came every time she thought of Wanda standing alone in that sunny spot in the schoolyard, looking stolidly without any expression over at the group of laughing girls after she had walked off, after she had said, sure, 100 of them and all lined. So finally, Maddie, she blinked away the tears. She removed her ears that were coming down again on her cheeks and thinking again of Wanda, the same way she's standing on a sunny spot during the recess period in the schoolyard, where number of girls she's surrounded by, and ultimately everyone asking how many dresses you have, and she's just giving one answer, 100 dresses I. Okay? So what this chapter is all about? What this chapter is all about? This chapter is not about the emotions which Wanda has suffered from. But actually, this chapter is about the emotions of all the children who suffer this kind of behavior. As this chapter has highlighted the problem of bullying in the class, in the school that is undergoing, right? And moreover, the writer also wants to depict the quality to understand the feelings of others, to have empathy towards others. Okay, to be empathetic towards others. So what is empathy means? See empathy. To understand the feelings of others. To feel human towards others. And this is what this chapter is delivering. Okay, many themes are being twined together. It is the goodness in one's character. It is understanding of the other human beings that has been brought out through this lesson. There is also the theme of bullying which has been brought about. Moreover, it is also to be innocent in your thoughts also. Because see, Peggy, although she is innocent, she is saving the other children from being bullied. But she has a different attitude towards Wanda. She is losing innocence at that time. To behave according to your age. To be sensitive. To have emotions. All these things, they have been brought about in this chapter. Right? So, this is one of the most touching chapter in the entire book, 100 Dresses 1 and 100 Dresses 2. And I think that you will never forget the character of Wanda Pentrovsky. So if we let us see that what are the main characteristics of Wanda Pentrovsky? What kind of girl? Yes? Introvert, of course she was. Introvert, as she's not disclosing her feelings to anybody. She is always remaining tight-lipped. Okay? Huh? Clean and tidy. Okay. What? Yeah? Receive? What it means? What? I'll talk to you later on about it. Okay. Then she is daily wearing that blue dress. Okay. She is, of course, a good artist. Right? Mentally strong. Yes, absolutely right. She was mentally strong. How she was mentally strong? Yes. She is daily being made fun of. She is always picked up. Picked up means to make fun of somebody. But she's never replying. Okay, but ultimately she's just twitching her shoulder at one or the other time, showing her expression. Moreover, most of the time, she always remained tight-lipped. Then, she was a mediator, okay. Mediator, how she is that Maddie was mainly? She is the victim over here. Clear? Right? Dreams of having 100 dresses. She's always having dreams of 100 dresses. She's a Polish girl. Right? Living at Boggins Height. You will give the background also. Okay? And if we talk about Peggy, yes, for Peggy, you must have many points. Peggy, what kind of girl? Yes. Peggy, what kind of girl she is? First of all, she is the most popular girl in the school. She is not Polish. American one. Hardworking. She is, of course, hardworking. It is not like that. We will present only the darker side of her character. She was, you can say, glowing picture of character also with curly hairs. Okay. Creative, good artist. She is sensible also. How she is sensible? Yes, because she is protecting the other children from being bullied. And whenever she is so sensitive, you can also write down. That when she sees an animal suffering, she has tears in her eyes. Okay? But has an indifferent attitude towards Wanda. Why? Because she because she hated that lie that Vanda was daily speaking, that she has 100 dresses, although she is coming to school and she is only wearing that one blue dress. Right? Other points? Careless? How you will prove it? She has forgotten. But she is also pricked by her consign. Okay, she was also pricked by her consign for what she has done with Wanda. This is the reason why, without being proposed by Maddie to go to Bergen's Height, she was ready to go there. Okay, and finally, when they were writing a letter to Wanda Pentronsky also, then what they have done? They wanted to write on a friendly letter. Actually, what was the purpose of writing that letter? It was to say sorry. Okay? It means that she was tricked by her consign. She wanted to feel sorry. Okay? She's little bit adamant. Not much, little bit adamant, because she's not ready to speak the word sorry. But she was justifying her own, you can say, making fun of Wanda. And she thought that it is just because of her that she has asked how many dresses you have, and she's really getting the idea of the various drawings, and this is the reason why she won the contest. Most popular girl of the class of room number 13, as everyone was expecting that Wanda is going to win the competition. Right? Then, what about Maddie? What kind of girl, Maddie? Kind-hearted. Okay. Then, sensible, sensitive, emotional. She did not belong to so rich family like that of Peggy, similar to that of Wanda Pentronsky, but not so poor as that of Wanda. Then, she wore hand-me-down clothes of Peggy, right? Then, yes? Okay. Then, insecure. Yes, insecure. She is not so courageous also. She is having the feeling of insecurity that she would not be, you can say, she would not be, she would lose Peggy's friendship otherwise. Yes, Kanishka, you can speak also. And moreover, she is not so courageous to speak against. Yes, give your points.
She wishes that Wanda has not left the town yet.
Okay, yes. She wished that she should not have left the town. She wished that she should meet her again and could say sorry to her. Right?
She holds herself responsible for the Wanda's misery.
Okay. Yes. Anxious about? Anxious about to know about Wanda. Okay? She wanted to know about her whereabouts. That where she has gone and where she lives now. Right? So this is just an overview of the characters of the three main girls that we have studied in this chapter, right? Yes, Kanishka?
Ma'am, done.
Done, okay. Finally, this chapter reading is complete. Tomorrow we will discuss the question answers, and there are innumerable extra questions we'll discuss. Okay, so have the understanding of the chapter proper first of all, then we will have the discussion. Okay, tomorrow we will discuss the question answers.